Hi, this video is showing the solution for the question 2.1d, and which the question says here, find the root or solution of the given equation, which is generally the intersection on the x-axis, using bisection method in Microsoft Excel. Well, you can use calculator for doing it, but it's quite a tough job for carrying out the solution in calculator. So generally we have to do in Microsoft Excel. So taking this equation y is equal to x square minus 2, we go into this. I've just written up some of them. Function of x is equal to x square minus 2. Now here we can't just write x square here, so we just left it like that, but try to understand that this is x square minus 2. And well, the range we don't know, I mean we have to find the value. So what first thing we need to do is we need to find two boundary, okay, in which a root lie within that. So how to do this? What we do is we just take a value of x and we make a guess here. So let's say we start with minus 4, we're going to take, or minus 5 if you want it, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3. And you don't have to repeat it. What you can do is you select any two cell like this, select, and then you drag it from this corner, and then it can go up to, let's say, some other values like that. Now we will put this, so we'll get the function of x now, meaning we'll put this x value in this equation to see what is the value in this. So in, we can put it here, like say for example minus 5, so we can say minus 5 square is 25, minus 2 is 23, so we can get the value 23, and we can get this. Now this is just a guess value. We are trying to, what is this, like we are taking this minus 5, you could have taken minus 6 also, just we are taking up some guess value. Minus 5, we put it here, we get the function value. Okay, so why we're doing it, in order to find where the root lies inside it. So let's do this one. So now, instead of putting it, solving and getting it, since you're using Microsoft Excel, you have an easy way of doing it. In order to put this in this and to get the value, how you do it, you, where you want the answer, you just keep the cell there, go and say equal to, and then what you have to say is x square minus 2, meaning this, the square of this minus 2. So you can say, just select this, that mean m4 is the address of this value, minus 4. And then you say multiply by, again click on this, so m4 into m4 meaning minus 5, m4 meaning minus 5 into 5, that is 2 times, that is showing like square, and then you say minus 2. So see, you get 23. Now to get the rest of the value, what you do is select the first one and drag it from the corner up to this. Now when you see this answer, you see this, according to the bisection theorem, if you take any two values, like this is A and this is B, okay, and if you put this A in this equation which is known as FA, and if you take this as B, and if you put in this equation known as FB, so this is FA and FB, and when you multiply this two, if it is less than zero, so of course this is plus, it'll be more than zero, so meaning the root does not lie between these two. Okay, so that's why we prepared it here. Now when we take the next one, again this 2 is positive, again the root does not lie between this. This is positive, if I take this is A, this is B, and this is FA and this is FB, again after multiplying this will be not less than 0, so the root doesn't lie between this. But if you see this one and this one, if you multiply this one and this one, okay, let's see, so you this one, so let me color this for you. So see, this is, if we take this as A and if this take as B, so this will become, like say for example, this is, if I take it as A and this is, if I take it as B, so this will become as, for me, FA, and this will become FB for me. So if I multiply this two, okay, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, which is less than 0. So definitely, one of the root lie between 2 and minus 1. So this is what the two range which we are trying to find out before we start this equation. So one we know that is here, and again, and then if you go on checking again for with this two, okay, if we see for this one, this two, if you multiply it, okay, is minus 1 into minus 2 is become plus, so it's not less than 0, so the root doesn't lie between these two. You know, the easiest way to check is if you're taking this two range, just check if both are plus, if both are minus, the root doesn't lie in between them. If one is plus, other is minus, or if first one is minus, the other one is plus, the mean root lie between them. So we can see from here, these two had a difference in sign. Now among these two, both are same, so again root does not lie between that. Again here, if you see the same sign, now in this case now, you can see again there's a good things to see here, that here is minus and here is plus. So if you multiply both, it's going to be less than zero. That means I can take this as A and I can take this as B, and this is going to be my F A and this is going to be F B. And then again all the sign and the same sign are there, so that means root doesn't lie. That means we are clear the root lie between this and this and this and this. So you can start from anywhere. You can start from, let's say we're gonna go for this one. Okay? So let's say A value, which is I'm taking as 1, B value, which is I'm taking as 2, and we're going to find out. So definitely we know according to theorem that root lies between 1 and 2 and minus 2 and minus 1. So I started with this one. So this is how you got the 2 value. Now let me select some cell and I make it in middle so that you can see in the value. Now what we can do here is, so if we got it A, we got B, we can find the value of F A and F B. How we can say is, we go here, say equal to, if A is this, how to get F A? You just put the value of A equal to 1 in this to get this. Now how you're going to get this is what, x square minus 2. So meaning what, the value of A has to be multiplied 2 times minus 2. So you say this, select it. Again say multiply, again click on it, so it comes that, and minus 2. And when you press it, the value of this comes here. In a similar way, if you want the value of B to come up, okay, is just what you need to do is come and drag it here. So for 1, it comes here, for 2, they calculate here. You can do it, see, you can check it, see. 2 to the 4, 4 minus 2 is 2. Now what is C? C is, according to the bisection method, is equal to A plus B by 2. So it's this plus this by 2. So you don't need to do it manually because we have to do a quite find a lot of range which has to be done automatic. What you can do is equal to say this value plus this value. Okay, put a bracket in this and then say by 2. So it comes to 1.5. So once you got this, now how to get FC is the same thing. If C is this, how to get FC? Just take this value, put it here and get the answer. So how are you going to do it? Equal to, what is the equation? X square minus 2, meaning this multiplied by again this minus 2, and we got the value. So we got the first row. Now how the rule says the bisection to proceed? They said once you get the C equal to A plus B by 2, which we have got it. Now they're saying to check if AFA value and FC multiply and check less than 0 or not. Now what you do is you don't have to multiply, just check FA value which is minus and FC value which is plus. If I multiply plus into minus will be definitely less than 0, isn't it? Plus into minus is what? Minus. And minus mean what? Less than 0. So they said if it's less than 0, then what you do is then make B equal to C. Otherwise, if they are not less than 0, if they are more than 0, then do A equal to C. But for me, right now, in this one, this is minus and this is plus. So minus into plus is minus, which is less than 0. So they said take B equal to C. So B equal to C meaning that the new B will be C, this one. So this C will come here and A value will remain as it is. Okay, so this C will come here according to this and A remain as it is. But if they are not less than 0, then you have to say A equal to C. That means in A, the C value will come here and B remain as it is. Now how to do this? how to program this automatically so that we can do for rest of it easily. Now we can't just pick up, I know, like for example, for my case here, FA which is here, FC which is here, sorry, this one, so plus minus, which is minus less than zero. So meaning for me, I have to do what, B equal to C. That means in this new B, the C value will come here, right? So instead of copying this 1.5 and bringing it here, it become manually, and then every step you have to do that. So which we don't want to do, we want to do automatic. So we to do it automatically, how are we going to program it? Is very easy. What you can do is you can write here like this, equal to, so what is going to come in B? In B, C value will come only when this condition is satisfied. So what you do is press equal to and write a formula, if, give a if condition and say like, say for example, put a bracket and say for example, what is that? FA. So FA multiply by FC, okay, put another bracket here and then check if this is less than zero according to the problem. If you see this, if it's less than zero, then what we do is then in the B value you bring what? C value. So in the B value bring the C value, so click here, otherwise, okay, bring this one, otherwise leave it with the old value. So click on this one. So what does it mean, like making you understand here? What you're doing is D5, that means you're multiplying this one and this one according to the formula, and you're saying that if it is less than zero, so what you do, B equal to C. B equal to C mean the new B value will be equal to, okay, C value, this one. So C is what? F5. So you're written F5 here. But if it's not true, then previous value of B should come here, which is what? Like C5. So I've written C5. And once you do this, they will do according to it. Now don't worry about this, just say okay with that. Did it work? What this says, not try to formula equal to or minus this one, even thing is formula, okay, 1 plus, okay, what they said, E5, so if this is less than 0, I think I have to see the command is, okay, let's do it again. I think this is some kind of formula. So if I'm saying it here, what's the formula? FA. So meaning FA, not this one, the value, okay, into FC, which is this one. Now that if this is less than zero, if that is less than zero, then you can say, if that is less than zero, then B equal to C. That means in B, the new C value will come up. Otherwise, it should come the previous value. So what's going to give? I think I'm just. Let me see what's the formula. If command in Excel. Yeah, that's right. If comma and then pass fail. That's right. So what's the problem is coming up? Oh, let's close it. If this is this, and if we close it, we found a typo. Yeah. So if you say yes, okay. So I think that's the way. I mean, this is how you're gonna give them. Even if they give you error, just say yeah, okay. It comes up. So see, it comes automatically. So since the values condition is right, like FA, which is this one, and FC, which is this. FA is this one and this one. If you multiply this one and this one, is less than zero. So what they're doing, B equal to C. In B, they bring in the C value. Now similar, you have to do for A. Similar. Similar meaning, now that was with FA and FC, right? So similar logic you need to apply here. You're going to say like if equal to if, you're going to say now, once you did with FA and FC, now you're going to do with FB and FC. So you're going to say FB into FC, if that is less than 0. Think in a similar way. FA and FC, you did it. So what you did, B equal to C, otherwise previous value. But the other said, if you do with something else, like say for example, if this is B, then if FB and FC is less than 0, then your answer is A should be replaced with the C value. So I'm going to say if FB, which is, let me explain you again. I'm going to say if FB multiplied by FC, if that is less than 0, okay, then here the value of C should come up. So I'll say comma, then this C value will come up. Otherwise, it will take the previous value. So which is this one? Close it. If they give you some time kind of this error, don't worry about it. Just say yes. It works here. Now see, it works. So you got this new value of A and B according to this theorem. And what advantage you're going to get is like, if you repeat it, it will show you how easy it's going to become up. So now if this is A, this is new B value, how to got FA? It's the same thing. Like what you're going to do is simply what you do is drag it, simply drag it. So this two will come according to this one. Now even this one C you want to, you just simply drag it, that will come according to that one. Now even C, if you're going to drag it, you're going to get this according to it. Okay, now once you got this one, so if you want this line now to continue, what you need to do is just drag it as much as you can. Okay, so the more you want down, you can go on down, there's no problem. Now if you see nicely, so C is the actual value root between, you know, we are trying to find the C, which is a real root. Okay, A plus B. So C, when you see, is going down, and we can see that C 1.414213, and somewhere around, somewhere if you want to be exact up to two decimal places, so you can see 4.142 is repeating itself, or 21 is repeating it. So wherever you want to finalize your answer, let's say for example, now see 213213213 is repeating, 2.3555 is repeating, 66 is repeating it. If you want to go more down, you can go down more. 6262 is repeating. Now see, now this one, after this, the value is not changing at all. So we can say that the final answer, you can say final root, okay, will be, we can take up one value, that is 1414213562. It depends on how much decimal. We can go more further, but then I think we can stick to this one. So this is one of the root we got it. Now we took from 1 and 2, and between 1 and 2, this is the one of the root. Now we can also do with minus 2 and minus 1, guys. We can do with minus 2 and minus 1, and we can find another root. Okay, so we can find another root. And how we can find it is, we took 1 and 2 the range last time. We can again do the same thing with range minus 2 and minus 1. Okay, we can do that. But before we do, what we can do is, before, if you want now this one, we can copy simply, and that will be your solution. So if you copy it out, and that, just copy this, and then you can just label the last one and just give some colors to say that this is one root. Now this is one root, you can see this one. Now similar, to find another root, simply take, if you see what is the another one, simply take A minus 2 and B what? Minus 1. So let's take simply A equal to minus 2 and B as minus 1. Okay? Minus 1. And we can find another one then. Now let's show you how easy it is now, because if you do with formula wise in Excel, and how easy to get the other value. Now simply what we do is, we just go here A to B, and we're going to say as minus 2, and b we're going to say as minus 1, okay? And same thing as it is. So you see the same value, and with only with minus sign is coming up. So nothing, no changes at all, and then this is your final another root which you want. You can just put it here as a copy paste, okay? So that's the solution. The same thing you need to do with this. The only thing, the only similar difference is x cube minus 2, they're saying. So instead of saying x square, we have to do for x cube. So what you do, you know, when you're using this formula, why we said b5 into b5? Because it's 2 times. So you just write here 3, and now for this formula, you just write b5 into b5 into one more, click it, 3 times will be coming up. And yes, this one is also important to find the range. You can say you're finding the range in which the two, or you can say just say in which the roots lies. Okay, so this one also, if you can give it, is better to show as a proof. And your bisection theorem, you need to give it according with that. Sorry, 1 minute was that. Yeah, before you start this one, solution, yeah. So you can say first, now this is not coming exactly, so yeah, and it's up to you how you design it. So we got the two value, that's it. And then we can go for the next, this one. So I'll produce the video for that also.